let's move on desiccant. So having said that, so desiccant has widely powerful tool in order to prevent the moisture. Whatever the moisture trapped inside the DHU, it will absorb. That's the most important. And it allows the occupant to see outside because they will not have any condensation. If any, the temperature difference, like it is a heavy shower fall, like torrential rain outside, where inside, you know, sometimes like you'll get at the, because of the temperature difference of the pain, you'll have the foggy effect. So because of the desiccant, it will not allow your IG to get into the foggy effect. So this will prevent for condensation basically or fogging effect. So the desiccant is playing vital major role in terms of IG process. You can see this in the bottom, you can see there is a filled desiccant as a nature if, you know, same color. Once it is absorbed, it'll be actually I identified as a blue color to differentiate it. It'll absorb like hydrocarbons or water water vapor inside. So this is how it's, you know, keep on gradually it absorb, and the durability, what the manufacturer says, the manufacturer differs, probably the 10 years if you keep it in an airtight container, when you get it into that, great effect you can get out of desiccant. So having said that, desiccant were introduced to remove the moisture trapped inside the IG unit. Some of the desiccant absorb not only the water, also the inert gases between the paints. So that would result in lower thermal performance. So whatever we select the desiccant should not absorb any inert gases, thermal performance gases we should not. So when the at the time of a purchase, we should be keep in mind that the desiccant should not absorb the inert gases. So that's in that's most prime job for us to finalize the vendor. That's the first most, and it should able to absorb water and hydrocarbons. That's the nature of this desiccant. It does the job, but it should, you know, it has to be, you know, noted. And it should not absorb the thermal performance gases, which having said that, like argon, xenon, krypton, those gases. And it should not contain pre-absorbed nitrogen. If it is already pre-absorbed nitrogen is there, thermal performance will be very less. The durability of desiccant will be very, very less. So the selection of desiccant also, these are the factors you need to be considered at the time of selection of desiccant or finalizing the vendor. And basically molecular sieve size in normal pore diameter is 3 angstrom, which expressed in terms of, you know, identify the desiccant diameter 3 angstrom. And it has aluminum silicate as a base and potassium as a catalyst, I mean cation. So that's the base of material which, you know, would help us to prevent the condensation. Next, we'll discuss about types of desiccant. This is the molecular sieve, which is widely used. This is a silica gel, the same as good as molecular sieve, but this is the because of the pore sizes are larger in size. So nowadays people not using it. I mean, it was obsolete, and presently also it's obsolete. There is no availability of silica gel right now. And zeolite, it was once upon time it was used. This also kind of desiccant, again this also obsolete. So which having said that earlier, it has a 3 angstrom like in a diameter, and the base aluminum silicate and potassium as a cation. It's a mixture of those. You can get this molecular sieve, silica gel similar to molecular sieve, but it with the larger pore size. And zeolite remove water molecular from the organic solvent and prevent condensation of the water molecule on the glass surfaces. So three types of desiccant which we discussed, out of which molecular sieve, the first one, which is a prime function, which widely used in the world. Let's discuss about primary silicon. Primary seals like silicons are used extensively, like exclusive or made of polyisobutyl, which is mean PIB, which is called polyisobutylene, based on formulations it's made it. And PIB, polyisobutylene, has a thermoplastic in properties. It can be applied on hot applied through the spacer bars by automatic lines with the butyl extrusion machines that will be widely used for dispensing this primary silicone. So, this is the picture. So, this is a separate machine. It's a primary silicone extruder machine which has a two nozzle, where the two nozzle through which the primary silicone which dispensing on the spacer. The spacer has the two sides. So, in a one, in a single stroke, the both sides will be applied. So, it will be uniformly applied. So, this is how the work is happening on the primary silicone on the surface of the aluminum channel. And quantity of butyl extrusion, like if anything is there, adjust to 2.5 grams per milli, and adjust in two sides, like you can adjust it. So, you can see here, this is the insufficient. So, there is no lack of, you can see there is a red color identified. There is a lack of silicone, primary silicone has been filled with it. So, there will be a loss, for example, internal breakages and irreversible breakages. For example, if used like this, having said earlier, the butyl in nature, it will it blocks this water vapor tightness. I mean, it prevents the water vapor gets into the DGU, as well as it is supports mechanical load, like wind load when it hits on the facade of the glass. So, if the due to the wind load, the glass may deflect. In order to deflection, to get this load in like a seismic load, like a flexible load. So, this butyl will help us in order to prevent that glass breakage at the time of wind load. So, we will have to be carefully, we have to fill with the primary silicone. You can see this primary silicone has been filled properly, which is slight excessive, because it will allow the slight, like 2.5 milligram, if you use excess of material extrusion on this edges. So, it will allow, for example, you can see the picture, it will allow. So, the glass movement absorber, if the glass starts moving it due to the high wind load applications, so it will absorb that glass movement and delay potential breakages, it won't. So, if the less silicone, primary silicone, will have a whereas the second picture, which I correct picture which I showed you, this is how primary silicone has to be filled on the, I mean extruded on the aluminum channel. Butyl application often defects. So, sometimes too much butyl in the corners. So, corners has to be, we have to be very careful. If it is less or too much, either will be a problem. So, it has to be very uniform. So, you can see this is the bend frame. So, you will have a problem. See, you see that other left hand side and right hand side. So, there will be a difference of primary silicone, will have a different effect. So, it has to be throughout the edges, it has to be uniform. Let's move on to this type of IGO sealant. This is a single pot. This is a two pot silicone. So, basically primary silicone, which is PIB, polyisobutylene, which is a single pot, which is a primary silicone. The next is a double side, I mean the two pot, which is silicone or hot melt. So, it will be a two pot silicone. So, primary sealant is a PIB, which is a polyisobutylene or butyl, it is called. And secondary sealant is silicone or polysulfide, it is like one part and two part components. In case of two part sealant, the mixing ratio of like a base A and a catalyst B should be the consistent, throughout the consistent, because you should not mix like the base, you whatever you take as a black, should be 1/10 of white of catalyst. So, that is the consistent we have to meet it, otherwise you will have a lot of effect like miscolor match and durability, share, a lot of problems would come. So, it has to be mixing is should be a consistent. So, based on the experience, you will get experience, expertise on this mixing. So, you will have to thoroughly, you have to go through the guidelines of the manufacturer. Like silicon manufacturer, whatever there is, have been informed. So, we have to strictly follow. So, if you mess, if you're not doing the proper mixing, the entire process, whatever so far you've done this pre-processing, tempering, framing, desiccant filling. So, the silicon mixing is not proper. So, you are allowing your DGUs get failed at the earliest. So, this is the last function, but but not least, you'll have to take care at the time of mixing. Next is properties of silicon. Let's see about it. Like raw material, I distinguish between raw material and what is function. For example, it's a polymer base, like it's a structural backbone, like it will give a structural strength. Basically, every IGU should have the structural strength. So, if the structural strength is not there, the glass will will fall from any moment. For example, if it is a skyscraper or a big story building, if you use as a facade, the structurally, if it is not strong, it is not held properly, it will fall off. So, it will be a big massive, it will be a lot of problem for occupant, not only the outside or inside, it will be a problem for everybody. So, it will be a structurally, it is a backbone. So, it is a polymer based and fillers, it is a body and strength, it will give a like lot of strength inside. And plasticizer, like plasticizer will help us in viscosity and strength. And pigments, as you all know about it, pigments will does a color effect. And UV resistance. UV resistance is most important because these structural silicon has been used for outside like weathering and structural silicon. You have exposed to the heat and moisture or chemical fumes or cleaning agent in order to prevent those abnormalities to come and affect or hit the silicon, we'll have to have a proper strength. So, thereby the UV, because when the sun is there, there'll be a ultraviolet radiation would be there. So, in order to protect that one, if it is not protected, it'll be your silicon would become a color change from presently it'll be a black, it may be a white or yellowish after that. And curing accelerator, chemical reaction cure. So, the curing accelerator is most important because it's all DG process. Today you apply, you should not wait for a week to cure because you will have to serve the customer in an immediate effect. So, that's why in an hour or maximum 4 hours is sufficient enough to dispatch your DGU. So, that's the curing accelerator will help you to dispatch a faster. So, the silicon should have the proper curing accelerator. Adhesion promoters, the bonding substrate, the adhesion promoters, it's massive. Again, this is one of the best quality out of silicon. If this failed, you don't have adhesion, then it will be a problem for everything. So, that's the best thing has in silicon, adhesion promoters, bonding to the substrates, like for example, aluminium or from glass to other surfaces. When they're glazing it, so it required. So, whereas here we are emphasizing here is silicon, the glass and aluminum substrate. Thixotrophic agent, which means sagging residence, which I told you, if you're doing it on the vertical glazing, you don't have a problem. If you have a horizontal, you'll have a problem. Even then, this has an agent, so it will prevent that sagging effect. So, it will give a structural flexibility. So, again additives, it will accelerating, retarding, so these are the chemical properties. And let's see, having said that, so our silicon, there are two types, one is organic and inorganic. Organic, it is classified as a polysulfide and polyurethane, whereas inorganic is classified as silicon and hot melt. So, I have been distinguished with the colors, like you can see this properties as the yellow. You can see this polysulfide which meets all the requirements, for example, elasticity, stress relaxation, shrinkage after cure and argon transmission rate. So, in polysulfide, if you take it as an organic as a polysulfide, polysulfide has excellent chemical resistance, adhesion is good for all the organic and inorganic, and sure hardness is almost all the organic and inorganic silicons are satisfied. So, this is the secondary silicon properties. Next, let us look at it function of secondary silicon. Structural bond, glass pan and spacer. Basically, it provides a structural benefit towards glass pane and protection of gas filled spaces from inflations like moisture vapor penetrations, chemical attack like cleaning fluids, glazing products. So, it will prevent that one and liquid water penetrations, rain, condensation, and it has a low moisture vapor transmission and gas diffusion rates. And adhesion glass adhesion to the glass and spacer substrate has a massive for this, and it has a long durability because of the nature of the silicon what we selected, and provide a good tensile and shear strength to the glass edge in space cell.